The Joe Rogan Experience.
Do you watch boxing?
Yes.
Did you watch Ruiz?
Yes.
What?
He got fat and he was partying.
Why did he do that?
He had a good time. Fucked up. Got rid of his trainer. He did a lot of things wrong.
At first, they were saying he lost too much weight. Did you remember that?
But that was just because there was a photo that he was doing, like, the Instagram angle.
Oh, is that it?
It's like him in the bathroom looking down.
Oh, you know, okay.
If you, like, have a camera and you pose it a certain way, you can make yourself look slim.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, I get nothing gets me more excited than a good boxing match.
Well, that fight should have been a great fight, but Andy fucked up.
Yeah.
He really fucked up.
And afterwards, no plan.
Afterwards, he was asking for a rematch. I'm pretty sure he trained himself, too, for that
fight. I think he did.
Yeah. Well, he was, I know for a fact.
Why would he do all that?
He was partying. Because he became the heavyweight champion of the world in an incredible knockout. And I bet everybody was kissing his ass. And he bought a Rolls Royce. He came to the podcast. When he did the podcast, he came in a Rolls Royce. Yeah. Woo! Which doesn't necessarily mean you're going off the rails, but it's a really good indication. Yeah, I mean, if he showed up in a fucking Caprice Classic, I'd be like, this guy's dialed in.
Yeah.
He's focused.
Yeah, he's going to get this one. That's right.
He's got
an
old cop car he's driving around in. You know?
No hubcaps.
Yeah. Shitty old bench seats.
Let's go get the championship.
Yeah, he's Rocky Balboa. But he had his chance, and they're not going to give him another one.
No.
Because he can beat a lot of guys.
Yeah.
But I don't know if he can sell a lot of pay-per-views. Especially after that second performance. The problem with the second performance is the second performance was so piss poor that you're going to need multiple, like, big wins in fights before people take you seriously again.
Again.
And he needs a real nutritionist. He really does. Even though he won being fat, there was a lot of factors in that fight. One big factor that I have heard from people who are very knowledgeable and in the know, insiders, was that Anthony Joshua was hurt in training. That he got rocked and maybe even got KO'd when he was training. And not too distant from the fight. Like 2 weeks out.
Really?
2 weeks out from the fight got KO'd. Yeah.
Oh, that's not good.
When you're a heavyweight and you're slinging those fucking gigantic fists at each other, like all those guys need to do is catch each other once. Just once. Boom. Apparently it just happens all the time. There was a Russian heavyweight boxer who was just criticized because he showed this video of a sparring session where he flatlines his trainer or his sparring partner with one punch. It happens. It happens all the time. For the knockouts you see in the ring, there's probably, you know, dozens more you'll never see with top flight guys that are just, you know, they're bringing in guys. Like, when Klitschko was the champion, he brought in guys like Anthony Joshua to spar with. He brought in guys like Deontay Wilder. He sparred with Deontay Wilder.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, these guys, they spar with killers.